Good evening. I'd like to call the regular village board meeting for December 21st, 2020 to order. Pursuant to the governor's disaster proclamation extending the statewide declaration through Saturday, January 9th, 2021, and Section 7E of the Open Meetings Act, I have determined that the requirement for an in-person meeting conducted under the Open Meetings Act is not practical or prudent tonight. This determination will allow a majority of trustees to participate remotely while the meeting remains an open public meeting. Will Village Clerk Turner please call the roll?
Mayor Pisak?
Here.
Trustee Carballo?
Here.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Here.
Trustee Dixit?
Here.
Trustee Hasse?
Here.
Trustee Sadat?
Here.
Trustee Winds? Trustee Winds?
Do we know if we expect Trustee Winds?
He's on.
He's on? So at this point, we can't confirm two-way communication. Trustee Winds, can you hear us? Trustee Winds, can you hear us?
I can hear you, yes.
I think I hear a very, very faint response.
Hear me now?
Trustee Winds, is that you?
Yes, here.
Okay, thank you. With that, I assume we have full two-way communication among the entire board. At this time, I'd like to ask everybody to stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
At this time, we don't have anybody in the boardroom. Assistant Village Manager Knight, do we have anybody queued up for public comment electronically?
No, Mayor, I see no one queued for public comment.
Thank you. We'll move on to meeting minute approval. May I have a motion to approve the December 7th, 2020 regular meeting minutes?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
We have a motion.
Trustee,
do we have a second?
Second.
I'm sorry?
Trustee Sadat, second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Hearing none, Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Winds?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Moving on to our voucher list approval, may I have a motion to approve the December 21st, 2020 voucher list in the amount of $549,360.94.
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
Trustee Hasse, second.
We have a motion and a second. Any village board discussion? Hearing none, Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Winds? Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Moving on to our consent agenda, items grouped as part of the consent agenda will be voted on together as a group unless a member of the village board requests that it be separately considered. Village Manager Ertmode, please provide an overview of each item.
Yes, thank you. Good evening, Mayor, members of the Village Board. Two items on the consent agenda this evening. Item A is acknowledgement of the monthly treasurer's report for November 2020. Item B is a resolution declaring the need for confidentiality still exists for the closed meeting minutes held on September 21st, 2020, related to pending litigation. With that, staff recommends approval of items A and B on the consent agenda. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you very much. At this time, would any trustee like an item to be separately considered? Hearing none, may I have a motion to approve items A and B?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Trustee Hasse, second.
There's a motion, a second. Any Village Board discussion? Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Winds?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Moving on to our regular agenda, first item is an ordinance amending Ordinance 2019-4825, granting an extension to the expiration date of building code variations granted to the DuPage AME Church Food Pantry located at 4324 Yackley Avenue. May I have a motion to approve this ordinance?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
Trustee Winds, second.
We have a motion, a second. Would Director Smetana please provide an overview of this item?
Yes, thank you. Good evening, Mayor, members of the board. As the mayor stated, the approval of the proposed ordinance will grant an extension to the building code variances that were granted to the DuPage AME Church so they can operate a food pantry at 4324 Yackley Avenue. As drafted, the proposed ordinance would grant an extension of those building code variances to April 28th, 2021. And that concludes my summary, Mayor.
Thank you. Is there any board discussion, starting with Trustee Kowitzel?
Have we gotten anything further from the church at this point?
No, we have not.
Okay. Thank you. That was my only question or comment.
Thank you. Trustee Winds, any comments?
No, thank you.
Trustee Dixit?
None for me tonight. Thank you.
Trustee Carballo?
No, thanks.
Trustee Hasse?
Nothing tonight. Thank you.
And Trustee Sadat?
Nothing tonight. Thanks.
Thank you. Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Winds?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Moving on, item B, a resolution authorizing a First Amendment to the Residential Solid Waste Collection and Disposal Agreement between the Village of Lisle and Lakeshore Recycling Systems. May I have a motion to approve this resolution?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
Trustee Sadat, second.
We have a motion, a second. Will Village Manager Ertmode please provide an overview of this item?
Yes, thank you, Mayor. The proposed two-year extension of the agreement was negotiated with LRS representatives and was presented during the December 7th committee, the whole meeting. The proposed extension includes a one-year rate freeze through June of 2022 for curbside subscription and the sticker program, as well as a multifamily pricing increase in year one of the extension, but not in year two. As a reminder, the first 3 years of the contract for multifamily pricing were held in the contract. Again, this was discussed at the Committee of the Whole meeting, and the amendment was drafted by the village attorney and has been reviewed by LRS as well. With that, staff recommends approval of the proposed extension. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you, Village Manager Ertmode. Any board discussion, starting with Trustee Kowitzel?
Just very pleased about the program and the more favorable circumstance contract that the village staff was able to secure. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Sadat.
Nothing further on this one. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Wins.
I have nothing, no.
I'm sorry?
No, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Trustee Hasse?
Nothing else, thank you.
Trustee Carballo?
Nothing, thank you.
And Trustee Dixit?
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Thank you. Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Wins?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Next is a resolution amending the Lisle Business Assistance Program to include a 50% reimbursement of on-premise consumption liquor license renewal fees for 2021. May I have a motion to approve this resolution?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
Trustee Sadat, second.
We have a motion and a second. Will Village Manager Ertmode please provide an overview of this item?
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Again, as discussed at the December 7th Committee of the Whole meeting, due to the continuing extraordinary economic impacts that the pandemic is proposing, particularly with the recent implementation of the statewide Tier 3 resurgence mitigations and its impact to the hospitality industry, the board directed staff to prepare an amendment to the business relief program that would include a 50% reimbursement for 2021 license costs for on-premise only liquor licenses. Staff has prepared the attached resolution for Village Board consideration and is prepared to begin that reimbursement process upon approval of the Village Board.
Thank you. Is there any Village Board discussion, starting with Trustee Kowitzel?
None other than I'm pleased that we can offer this relief to these businesses, and it's another opportunity to encourage people, as everyone well knows, to shop local and support our businesses.
Thank you. And Trustee Sadat?
This is a really good step towards giving some kind of relief back to our small businesses. We should be considering many more of such proposals. Granted, we have the money. That would be all.
Thank you. Trustee Dixit?
Nothing further. I think the other two trustees said it well.
Thank you. Trustee Carballo?
Nothing further. Thank you.
Trustee Hasse?
I'm just happy to see the businesses getting some more relief. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you. And Trustee Wins?
I have nothing now. Thank you.
Thank you. Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Wins?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Next is an ordinance for the levy and assessment of taxes for the fiscal year beginning May 1st, 2020 and ending April 30th, 2021 of the Village of Lisle, County of DuPage, State of Illinois. May I have a motion to approve this resolution?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
Trustee Hasse, second.
We have a motion and a second. Would Finance Director Schuler please provide an overview of this item?
Good evening, Mayor and members of the board. The village levies property taxes for the purposes of general corporate, police protection, IMRF, FICA, police pension, and liability insurance. The general corporate portion of the levy funds a portion of public safety salaries. The tax levy was discussed at the December 7th, 2020 Committee of the Whole meeting. In accordance with the direction provided at the meeting, the tax levy ordinance has been prepared without an increase and will remain equal to 2019 at $4,924,129. The average existing property owner should see a reduction in the Village of Lisle portion of their tax bill due to the new properties being added to the tax roll. The tax levy ordinance must be approved by the Village Board and filed with DuPage County by the last Tuesday in December.
Does that complete your presentation?
That concludes my comments. Yes, it does.
Thank you. Is there any board discussion, starting with Trustee Kowitzel?
I am delighted to once again this year hold the line on the property tax levy. In a difficult year, this is the most fair and equitable way to, and impactful way to positively affect all taxpayers. It speaks to the ability for people to have a roof over their heads, whether they own or whether they are affected by property taxes through renting. This is possible through stellar fiscal management on the part of staff and the PSAC administration. And this is occurring not just this year, where it's a year where many people are in crisis, but this is continuation of a practice that we've had for several years now, possible even while contributing to the pension in excess of contributions required by law to address negative amortization of that plan. So just very, very pleased about this. Thank you.
Thank you. Trustee Hasse?
I'm just happy to see us holding the line and trying to help our residents as much as we can. That's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you. And Trustee Wins?
I have nothing. Thank you.
Trustee Sadat?
Nothing further. Thanks.
Trustee Carballo?
Nothing further. Thank you.
And Trustee Dixit?
Nothing further. Thank you.
Thank you. Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Wins?
Aye.
Trustee Carballo?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Moving on, item E is an ordinance approving the abatement taxes levied for 2019 for general obligation refunding bonds, alternative revenue source, series 2016 of the Village of Lisle, DuPage County, Illinois. May I have a motion to approve this resolution?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
We have a motion. Do we have a second? Anyone for a second?
Trustee Dixit, second.
Thank you. Would Finance Director Schuler please provide an overview of this item?
Thank you. In 2016, the village issued $3.7 million in general obligation refunding bonds for the Village of Lisle Benedictine University Sports Complex. The outstanding balance at the end of fiscal year 2020 was $3.1 million. The bonds will be paid off in fiscal year 2032-33. The village has pledged incremental hotel motel tax revenue for the payment of the principal and interest on the bonds instead of paying it through the property tax levy. The ordinance on the agenda this evening abates the property taxes that would have been levied for tax year 2020. Items related to the levy are brought to the board together at the same meeting to improve transparency. It is estimated that at the end of the current fiscal year, the fund balance will be about $420,000 in the pledged hotel motel tax fund. As part of the budget process, staff plans to recommend including a transfer from the hotel motel tax fund for an additional year of debt service to shore up the fund due to the decline in the hotel motel tax. The pledged hotel motel tax fund balance at the end of FY21-22 is estimated about $589,000 with the transfer of the fund. That concludes my comments.
Thank you. Is there any board discussion, starting with Trustee Kowitzel?
None, thank you.
Trustee Dixit?
None, thank you.
Trustee Carballo?
None, thank you.
Trustee Hasse?
Nothing tonight, thank you.
Trustee Sadat?
Nothing, thank you.
And Trustee Wins?
Nothing. Thank you.
Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kowitzel?
Aye.
Trustee Dixit?
Aye.
Trustee Hasse?
Aye.
Trustee Sadat?
Aye.
Trustee Winds?
Aye.
Trustee Carvalho?
Aye.
Mayor Pisak?
Aye, and the motion passes. Moving on to officials and staff reports, we'll start with Trustee Dixit.
Nothing other than wishing everyone a happy and Merry Christmas, as well as a Happy New Year. We've gone through a lot this year, and I hope that next year will be a better year.
That concludes your report?
It does.
Thank you. Trustee Coetzel?
I too would like to wish everyone the blessings of the season.
And that concludes your report. Thank you. Trustee Carvalho?
I too want to wish everyone a happy holiday, and I think everyone's mindful of the year that we've had and the struggles that many people have gone through, and we wish that the new year is better for everyone, and that we see miracles, large and small, in the year ahead. Thank you.
Thank you. Trustee Hasse?
Just a few things tonight. First off, I wanted to address something from our prior meeting in December. I wanted to acknowledge that I had made a mistake at our last meeting when we were discussing Commissioner Bauer. My figures were incorrect in what I had stated, and he has actually attended approximately 75% of the planning and zoning meetings. So I did want to apologize publicly to Commissioner Bauer for my comments. Secondly, I'd like to ask that everyone please keep the residents and staff at Brookdale in their thoughts and prayers, especially during the holiday season. There have been an increased number of COVID cases there. A friend of mine whose grandma lives there currently has COVID, and it's just a scary time, especially during the holidays. And then lastly, I'd like to wish everyone a safe and happy holiday season. To all of our village staff and all of the residents at home, please enjoy this time with your families and friends and loved ones. I know it is a little different this year for everybody, but I think we can all, you know, stay the course, and I'll do the best we can and stay safe, and I'll see you in 2021. That's all.
Thank you. Trustee Sadat?
Just echoing the sentiments of everybody else on the board today. You know, we seem to be seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. We seem to be coming out of this pandemic. I just want to thank everybody who has worked to keep a sense of normalcy through this time. Those who adopted and adapted their ways of just working and keeping our economy afloat, especially all the back and forth that the staff has done to figure out different ways of channeling money in to help support our businesses, our residents. You know, I, as a village trustee, and like many of you else on the board, we receive a stipend, and I was trying to figure out a way to invest that back into some of our grants that we have going, and you know, right now, there is no real mechanism to donate that money that we're receiving, even though it is $1,200 annually. But one trustee making $1,200 contributed with everybody else on the board will mean a whole bunch to our Lisle business relief programs that we have. We need to find and explore a mechanism that makes it easier for us to reroute this. Upon asking, I was told that there was a code that that was in our village code where the stipends couldn't be deferred into a particular organization. So we should really think about looking at something like that, just ways of pooling together and working together to help fund some of our small businesses and challenges that they're facing. So I'm very grateful for the staff for the work that they have done, but as we're on a board and we do receive these stipends, we should find a way of at least, if you choose to, forego the stipend and defer it into an organization of our choosing from the village. Lastly, I'm just, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, and ultimately, just a very, very Happy New Year. Everybody, let's come on the other side cheering and really adopting everything else that we have learned today and throughout this past year and into a brand new future. Thank you.
Thank you. And Trustee Wins?
Hi, thank you very much. My dog has just entered the room with a loud bone, so if you hear some ruckus in the background, please forgive me. I don't know how he got back in the house. Happy holidays to everybody. It's been a very, very difficult year, and everybody's tried to come together and figure out alternative ways to survive. And everybody deserves a little extra recognition for that. So thank you all for that. There's been a lot of different little organizations that have been popping up and doing some good work around town, and I'd like to thank people for doing that as well. Several people have reached out to me and asked if they can contribute in ways to some of the organizations I've been involved with, which was surprising because we were facing some difficulties in fundraising this year, and our numbers are down from the amount of people that are able to contribute, but we're holding pretty steady with the amount of the contributions. So it seems that those that are getting through this are finding ways to just give a little extra, and that's been fantastic. I've been contacted by a few residents who are having a difficult time with some of their SNAP programs and things that have been limited, and they're not really that familiar with how to seek out some other alternative measures to get some relief in that way. So I've been working with them, and I want to thank them for feeling the comfort level to reach out in those difficult conversations. I've been there myself, and I just want to encourage those to continue to reach out, and I'll do my best to put you in contact with the right organization that might be able to help. So thank you all very much. Thank you, staff, all the elected officials. I really do appreciate you. And that's all I have for the night. Thank you.
Thank you. And I'd like to wish everybody a happy holiday season. Keep the faith through this difficult period of time, whichever faith that may be. I would like to give a little update on the DuPage County Health Department call I participated in this morning. Over the past week, approximately 13,000 doses of vaccine were received by the DuPage County Health Department and distributed to area hospitals for the first distribution of vaccine. The numbers aren't quite in yet, whether actually 13,000 doses made it out into the public or into the first responders, the hospital workers. But the health departments will keep track of any doses, as well as any unusable doses that expired because they ran out of time. There's only 5 days once they're removed out of the deep freeze. There's 5 days to administer them. They'll keep track of illnesses, any adverse reactions, all data surrounding them, and I'm promised that they will be publicly conveyed for transparency purposes on both where the vaccine is being distributed, that it's equitably being distributed throughout the state of Illinois and throughout the area, as well as what the outcomes of them are. But that's good news. It continues to move on. The second shipment of vaccines is expected this week from both sources. So that'll only increase the speed. But that's good news. We still need to continue what we're doing. But the vaccine is making its way out there. So with that, I want to wish everybody a happy holidays and a new, brighter looking 2021. With that, I'll move on to staff reports this evening. Any staff reports?
Nothing this evening, Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you. May I have a motion to adjourn?
Trustee Kowitzel, so moved.
Trustee Wynn, second.
Clerk Turner, please call the roll.
Trustee Kwitzel.
Aye.
Trustee Winds.
Aye.
Trustee Dixit.
Aye.
Trustee Hossie.
Aye.
Trustee Sadat.
Aye.
Trustee Carvalho.
Aye.
Mayor Pisak.
Aye. We are adjourned for this evening. Give us a couple minutes to reset our recording equipment, and we'll continue on with our committee of the whole meeting.